hills of San Francisco, you can see joggers and cyclists sweating up a storm, even in the foggy chill.
Around Beijing, their fellow athletes are taking training to new heights, inspired by personal and national pride.
In this episode, an exclusive look at how the Chinese National Gymnastics Team prepares for the 2008 Beijing Olympic Games, and personal stories of two world champions, their talent, drive, and the pressure they and their families will face when they compete before millions of fellow Chinese. Then Chinese Wushu, or Kung Fu as it's known in the U.S., is waging its toughest battle, the battle to become an Olympic sport. Finally, how a pentathlon world champion multitasks for a medal at the Beijing Games, the first Olympics ever held on Chinese soil. All coming up now on Beijing, Are You Ready? Less than 500 days before the 2008 Olympics begin, the entire city of Beijing is under pressure to be ready. But that's nothing compared to the pressure the Chinese National Gymnastics Team is feeling.
This is a rare glimpse of the Chinese National Gymnastics Team, usually off limits to the media. Any one of these athletes could be standing on the podium in the 2008 Games, an incredible honor in itself, but even greater because the Beijing Olympics will be the first ever on Chinese soil.
This is where they train, National Gymnastic Arena in the eastern part of Beijing. It's early in the morning, but you can already feel the intensity here. They know every day of training counts because they've spent most of their lives in the gym. Some of them are children, as young as
13. 我们是从小就等于是自食其力，自己很多东西都要去自己做，不像平常的孩子都有父母在帮助他们。虽然说有的时候很羡慕他们的快乐时光，然后有时候可以放长假，每天可以跟父母天天在一起啊，有时候还可以撒娇啊，跟我们比起来，他们确实很幸福。但是我们也有我们的幸福，因为我练了体操以后学到了很多东西，然后呢交到了很多朋友。
The senior citizens are in their early to mid-20s and have never known what it's like to be a carefree teenager.
我想我们以后可能会过上普通的生活，而且我想我们现在过的生活可能普通人是没办法感受的，因为我们这种生活是普通人不能够触及的。
But until their retirements, they can look forward to 6 days a week of intense training. The work is hard, and there's evidence the training is paying off in a big way.
In 2006, both the Chinese men's and women's teams won the overall world championships. So the expectation and pressure to win at the Olympics is beyond high.
Then there's pressure from the team's past glory. It stares them in the face every day. The team's 51 Olympic and World Championship gold medal winners are honored in the gym's most prominent place. Gymnasts also walk among legends who've already achieved the dream and want to do it again, like Olympic gold medal winners Tung Haibin and Yang Wei. But even a gold medal is no shield from Olympic pressure.
每次拿完冠军，从走下领奖台那一刻开始，都是从零开始的。 而且我们08年的选拔也是靠积分，不是靠上一届的冠军成绩。以前的一些成绩基本上都不太管用。Zhang
Nan won a gold medal in the 2006 Artistic Gymnastics Championships. She's the team captain and has the respect of the younger gymnasts. But she's also competing against the youngsters for a chance to make the 2008 Olympic team.
2004年的情况可以说是我在奥运会名单里可以说是，基本上已经是定好了的。但是这一次我是要靠自己的努力，去一个一个跟他们小的去拼。And
the younger gymnasts have bodies that are more flexible and less punished by time.
现在对我来说压力确实很大，因为现在我们一些小的已经，就是说开始逼得我很紧。 然后他们的水平也在不断的提高。因为我的现在的身体情况还有伤病情况都不是很好，所以说这次对我来说准备奥运会也是蛮艰难的。
Sometimes the pressure is almost too much for even the toughest athletes.
去年对我来说，一开始是打算不练的，但是一想到自己还没有登榜，自己的梦想还没有实现，所以呢，就选择了坚持练下去。
Coaches can nurture and motivate an aging champion to reach for gold one more time.
不管今年结果怎么样，能不能上世锦赛，自己也会坚持到零八年。等到零八年的名单宣布的时候，我在名单内争取上奥运会，在比奥运会的时候，不管怎么样，就是说自己都好好的拼一把。然后如果要是没有争取上奥运会的话，我想的是选择退役。
But the coach's support also adds to the pressure an athlete feels.
因为我的强项是平衡木，但是往往很多有好几次的很好的机会，我自己都没有把握住。带我的女教练刘导嘛，她就是说真的，我确实是很感觉对她很愧疚，很对不起她，因为她对我也是一次一次的希望，但是最后是一次一次的失望，所以也是因为这一点，我觉得不管怎么样，自己应该坚持下去。就是说，这个人就是说，一定要懂得去知恩图报，去回报自己的教练。
Pressure from coaches, a legacy of past glory.And phenomenal recent success is a lot for even these strong bodies to bear. Now add to that fact that they'll be competing on their home turf with an entire nation expecting a repeat of the 2006 World Championship victory.
压力是肯定有的，但是我想压力可以化作动力，因为在中国北京的奥运会是千载难逢的一次，所以就是说自己不管怎么样也要去好好把握。
During that lifetime opportunity, the team will walk into Beijing's National Sports Stadium, knowing that 1.3 billion of their countrymen will be watching.
因为零八年是在北京嘛，咱们自己的土地上，然后，所以我们肯定就更希望能够表现出自己的很好的一面，来展示给国人吧。
That's the kind of discipline coaches hope will stay with the athletes as they hone their skills every day. But every day of training carries risks.
以前训练中主要担心就是受伤，希望不要受伤，因为一受伤的话可能会严重的影响进度吧，然后这是也是我们最害怕的东西。
Even a day without injury takes a toll on these young bodies.
一天练完之后很累，然后还有一些伤病吧。队医主要负责一些按摩，然后底标像扎针之类的，还有一些各种各样仪器帮助我们疗伤吧。
After a hard day of work, most people in their early 20s would be hitting the bars and hanging out with friends, but not these gymnasts.
一天训练完会很累，练完以后就做一些牵拉放松。然后有的时候要是感觉很累，就会去泡泡澡，然后蒸蒸桑拿。回到房间以后，就说自己的时间很少，有的时间会看会儿电视剧、韩剧，然后或者听听音乐。
平时有时候会玩一玩电脑，然后或者看球，我比较喜欢足球。
Gymnasts in training live as a team in dormitories. And oftentimes, their thoughts turn to their families.